This program was made possible by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting, the John D. and Catherine C. MacArthur Foundation, and additional support from Latino Public Broadcasting, National Endowment for the Arts, National Asian American Telecommunications Association, and others. A complete list is available from PBS. And contributions to your PBS station from viewers like you. Thank you.
You can walk around this campus.
I think that's why they're late, those pants around the knees.
95% of the time, there's very few boys as appropriately dressed.
It's sad because the pants thing started with, I've been to jail and they took my belt, be afraid of me. Snoop Doggy Doo and everybody else. I think it's like they want to look the more hood, ghetto, the better, whatever. But it was like, who's going to stand at the front door and check this at 8 o'clock every morning?
Now, in my class, they follow the rules. If a girl comes in and she's dressed immodestly, she leaves.
And you can't wear that.
Or I go and call her mother, ask her mother, do you know what she has on today?
I'm about to say, yes, she dressed her.
Yes, well, this is not appropriate.
It starts with us, too, you know? And I see it every day. I see a lot of teachers come in here wearing buck-ass wild stuff. I'm not saying that they have to wear a shirt and tie now, right? But at least they weren't wearing red hair, purple hair, blue hair, your psychedelic hair.
Are you proposing a dress code for teachers?
It starts with us.
Okay, great. So at our next meeting, I will publicize the fact that we are going to be discussing a teacher dress code. I think we'll have a full house.
What's up, Fairfax?
For the competition for decathlon, and I'm just really nervous because I'm so scared. What if, I mean, I know I'm gonna do well, but I'm just scared.
This is hard work, but there's nothing. There's no other activity outside of your normal school day that has more rewards than this. Nobody in this room is quitting. That's not an option.
Oh my God. You're making dirt. Shh, stop talking.
Russia. Oh. Nobel Peace Prize in 1904. Try to get one of those in 1904.
Everyone quiet. Quiet, please. And please pay attention to me.
You know, Ludwig Wittgenstein, greatest genius of all time. The only philosophical rule is that which cannot be spoken should be passed over in silence. Shut the fuck up.
I'm very giving. And I like to save animals from homeless people.
But shut up.
And
she has no emotions. Everything she says, everything she does is fake.
Oh, beautiful.
Elsa's lying all the time.
Elizabeth's
quiet.
Elizabeth's real quiet.
Everybody else sucks. And dishonesty and falsity is the number one crime.
Boris is just unhappy because he's lonely and he has no friends. So he's trying to rationalize his loneliness in life and trying to.
I don't get close to people. That's fine. I'm fine with that. I like it that way. Now, the people who get falsely close to another human being, now that's wrong.
Like you?
No, like you.
Okay, wait a second. Hey, everybody, Elizabeth has something to say.
Yes. She's supposed to be studying. Hello.
Hi.
Good morning.
Good morning. Did you participate in any of the debates personally?
Personally, no, I didn't. I was too...
Yeah, you did.
Okay, I did?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
One Friday, they had an issue that very much interested you, and that issue was... And that was the first time where you realized that I can be an active part of this organization.
Yeah. Mr. Sugden doesn't want you to lie because he's the coach, so he can't say that. But we want you to lie.
Yeah.
Lie.
I never tell you to lie, Elizabeth.
Lie, Elizabeth. Sorry.
Thank you.
Tell me what the lady said. Well, what did she ask you before that?
What's my phone number?
Yeah, funny, Kendra. Just tell me what was bothering you.
The guy seemed to want me to take some fucking, assessment. Students at some time. Placement classes, most commonly known as special education, because staff does not take the time to see what the child's educational background is like. I should know. This happened to me.
Did she just do your homework for you?
No, I was absent for 2 days, so she's helping me.
You know that's who?
Who?
That's for what?
What?
When?
When?
Why?
Why?
Where? What are those five words?
Who?
Mm-hmm.
What? Where? Why?
Mm-hmm. You know, you gotta believe that you can do it. If you don't believe in yourself, then you can't.
I go to counseling with Ms. Sharp.
Wendy Sharp, school psychologist.
Everybody has problems that they need to figure out. I get depressed.
Why don't you tell me
what's been
where you're at from the last time we were in here?
She helps me get things out that I need to just get out there, you know, and put them out, spill them out on the table. Because in my head, it's just all this jumb stuff and it never goes anywhere.
Start coming up with your excuse for not graduating because you didn't pass your English class.
I'll be on time tomorrow.
Thank you very much.
I'm gonna get a fail in this class. Because I've turned one project in and I've already had like six. So I'm doing really bad.
What's going on? Take one.
Take one, okay. struggling in Ms. Kim's class.
My concern is this is supposed to be a simple project that takes a student 3 hours. Because you're getting so abstract, you're getting so detailed, you've turned it into a week. Now you're into your second week.
This is my thing so far.
What did you get it from?
The Elegant Universe. My mother's reading this. It's about like space and how space is more like a fabric. Here's like an example. See how it's dented in like that on the fabric of space.
When was this project due?
Monday.
And you're turning it in when?
Tomorrow, Friday.
We can give you more time to be able to get that stuff done because that's the rules of the road for us.
My teachers actually, by law, are required to give me extra time on certain things because I'm a special ed student.
It would either be an incomplete, which you would have to complete, or a drop fail. I don't want to see it fail.
You're not a retard.
Yeah, I am.
No, you're not. Why would you say that?
I don't know, because I can't get anything out on time.
At the end of the semester, the amount of work that's due for this one semester, mm-hmm. you will do in the whole year.
Yeah.
It'll be good for you in June when you say, I did it. I didn't get an easy way out. I succeeded. And you're going to succeed.
Just going to school, working, and figuring out what college I'm going to go to.
Derard has a tremendous physical ability. I mean, he's a great athlete, very good player.
He's just trying to prepare himself now for college, filling out his applications.
It's the last 3 weeks of the quarter or whatever, so it's time to buckle down, get them grades straight.
They're gonna make sure he has his core classes, make sure he has the SAT score, he has a qualifying score,
I'm not worried about graduating or nothing because I know it's not that hard to do. But as far as my grades now, they're not looking so good.
So you worried about it?
A little bit. I mean, anybody would be worried about what school they're going to if you want to go. I got some good news from the coach today. She said that it's still early or whatever, so don't stress about not getting a scholarship already, but I'm kind of worried about that.
I know I'm going to do everything in my power. You know, every scout that comes through, I'm going to tell them about him.
I'm a good player or whatever, and I deserve to go to a decent school or whatever to play football.
Basically, it's up to you. As long as we've got the right school colors, okay, and something that's appropriate, you can't show your navel.
Oh my gosh, okay? No.
You can't show your nipples, and that's it. Okay.
Don't you think he's cute? Look at him, he's so adorable.
What are you looking for, a uniform or a boyfriend?
Both.
Would you want to cheer on Saturday if you pick up enough stuff during the week?
Huh? Which Saturday?
This Saturday, we have playoffs. We could put you in some red pants. Would you be up for it?
Yeah, I would. Yeah.
Really?
All right.
Ready?
Oh, Lord, help me.
Shoot, shoot, take that ball to the hoop.
Wait. I've been stretched in places I've never been stretched before in like 4 damn years, and it hurts like hell. But it's fun though, it's fun, it's really fun. The one memory.
I'll get back to you on that one because I really have no idea.
I would like to forget.
Well, seeing as how I'd like to forget it, I forgot. Sorry.
I have no recollection. The memory is that bad.
There's not really anything I'd like to forget.
Our football games in general. I mean, I'd never forget them. I always think about them.
I learn from every experience. I don't see my getting tickets and almost getting locked up as something I'd like to forget.
The day I was brutally, brutally violated by the ROTC squad and my school, I was beaten publicly. Would be? Well, of course, I was the agitator, I will admit. I did make fun of about 500 kids.
It really hurts, you know, that guys lie to you. Why do guys have to lie to you? You know, why do guys have to hurt you?
The death of Yevgeny.
I woke up feeling really shitty. Yeah, I didn't really know why. Until I remembered what the day was today. And last year, on this day, I had my abortion, and I woke up this morning, you know, I'm like thinking about it.
Okay, it's recording someone else's tab for you. Can I tell?
Yeah. Lucy's sister died in childbirth, and she brought a little boy who was adorable to visit, was part of this group once.
Oh, he's so cute. What are you going to say to him? When he starts crying, I mean, when you start crying and he starts going,
he really doesn't understand yet.
Of course not.
His mom loved him dearly, and she went through the pregnancy out fine. She didn't abort the baby. She could have. She didn't do it. She gave her life for the baby. So we're not going to tell him, oh, your mom. No, we're going to tell him who his mom is. We're going to not tell him that she died giving birth.
Lucy, I don't want you to take, I don't want you to feel like you screwed up when you said this, but when you said my sister could have gotten rid of it, but she had it. I went, oh my God, Carla's gonna just lose it. And I'm gonna just lose it. Isn't that what happened for you? I felt it. I felt like a knife was just going. I hurt for you because I know that that was real hard and you're still processing that. I knew Lucy didn't mean it that way. Mm-hmm. And for me, I think it's easier to think about my abortion because I was from a mindset that, you know, even though it's just different in Buddhist culture, we don't see that little bitty dot yet as a life until it's fully functioning. That's why we say, when is the first breath? That is your birth time. Not when you were conceived. But that's just this particular astrological bent that I have from my cultural upbringing. So I just want to make you all sensitive to that too, that sometimes we hook each other in our feelings and our words just from where we're coming from, and it's hard. Let the grieving come and let it roll.
I wanted to be like, you know, like, be like, get married or whatever, and not having kids, and then I'll have a good job and everything, and then just be like, hey, mom, guess what, I'm pregnant. Everybody be like, oh my God, I'm so happy. I wasn't ready, not like mentally ready. I wouldn't be committed, like, to the point where I was just like, okay, you know? I know I wouldn't be.
No, seriously though, the SAT, you have a really good opportunity here. Look, this is a $750 course. You have to do the work yourself. And this is what you're gonna be doing in college. You have to do it yourself.
Boy, except like you won't leave me alone. Like,
I don't wanna hear any crap.
Here you are, like you're all doing your work, and then like 5 seconds later you're in my face again.
I don't wanna hear any excuses. You
no,
have
that's
no
not an excuse, dude.
How old are you?
How old are you?
Yeah, bigger means small, paltry, or stingy's close. Well, and if it was lush, was it big or small?
Big.
Right.
I think it's C is the answer, so then E would be wrong, because you just said the answer wrong. C's wrong also? Okay.
You gotta be careful.
See, I need to study my vocabulary.
Okay, that's cool.
But I'm not gonna break a 1,000 on my SAT scores. And that makes me feel very stupid. That makes me feel like extremely stupid.
Again, like I'm Jenno, retarded when
Jenno,
it comes
you are
to
resisting.
Math.
You are resisting.
I'm not resisting. It's like a foreign language.
Okay,
it's
I understand. Like, no, I understand.
No, you don't. Like, that's the thing. You got fucking, what do you get, like 1590 on your 18AS score?
This is the SAT. Okay. You know the name of the test.
You better catch up.
You just gotta have heart in this kind of stuff. Your heart's not in it.
No, it is.
You haven't written anything.
You have 4 SAT books. Have you opened one of them?
Yes.
It's the opposite of someone who lacks something.
Someone who
has a lot of something.
Yes, a lot of. That. Right, martyrs have a lot of suffering.
So what's today, Jen?
SAT.
Are you ready?
No. Oh, fuck. How do I work this calculator?
We have a half an hour. Why are you sweating?
I don't know. I don't know where I'm going.
You know, why do you wait till last minute?
I have enough. It's not my backpack. It's my backpack.
Do you have my social security number?
I have your birth certificate, but it has a different name on it. I mean, it has your last name plus another one. Is that okay?
No.
Just take this. Don't lose it. Goodbye. My pens! My pencils!
Are we supposed to bring...
Do you have a pencil?
Yes, but like, okay. Where are they?
Oh, this isn't my day! This is my day!
Hi, I'm Jennifer. I'm laid off. I have my social security card and my birth certificate and a camera person. But I'm moving. All in a day's work. I think I did okay.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Remember, if you're going in at the end of the day, some of these judges have already seen like 15, 16 speeches. So it's up to you to kind of keep your energy level up.
I'm not doing this.
Hi.
Hi, Elizabeth.
Hi.
Hi.
I kept on sticking with my speech, and the thing was, like, first time I said it, I cried, and I think I went through the whole speech, just being strong, and then when I said the last word, I just cried, and I don't know why I cry, because I don't want to cry, you know? I shouldn't have any reason to cry anymore, you know?
Have you ever hungered for something so much that you would choose to leave behind everything, including your own family, in order to search for it? My mother did. She had a dream to become something, to improve herself and her life when she came to America. My mother grew up on a farm in Gangwon-do, Korea, where she had to dedicate her life to the development of her three older brothers. If she didn't, my mother would be disciplined in some way, because it was seen as selfish of her not to respect them. My mother raised me very strictly, like her mother did. Whenever I broke her rules, she would punish me. But sometimes I felt she beat me instead of disciplining me.
In life, sometimes, like, everything isn't right and wrong. And you have to accept that it could be in between.
She began to yell at me, "Why aren't you concentrating?" And then she hit me. Later, my mother came back into my room, apologizing, saying she loved me and that she was sorry. As I looked at the bruises my mother gave me, I asked myself, "Why do you hit me if you say you love me? Is this love?" But I forgave her, because as she hugged me, I saw her cry. It made me feel good, because she was really sorry this time. However, when I was 15, my mother and I had another argument. She grabbed the closest object near her and threw it at me. I was fed up with her abuse, and years of "I'm sorry" became lies again. My hate, anger, and frustration grew and forced me to call the police. I thought for once they could help me.
I don't want anyone to view my mom as a bad person, or a good person, or view me as a bad person or good person.
My mother felt what she did was right, because it was discipline, like in her country. She also felt I had brought shame onto her. Many Koreans would think, what kind of daughter would do such a thing, to dishonor her mother that way? Even my own best friend thought this. I was confused. Unfortunately, the country that taught me how to get help never told me the consequences I would have to face. I felt I grew up in a country where rights, opportunities, and equality ruled, not the need to sacrifice my wants for others, as my mother did. So why did my Korean neighbors see me as a dishonorable, foolish child? I started to hate being Korean, even though I was born in America.
I just realized how much I hurt my mom, and how much, you know, I brought shame onto her. And, like, I realized how important she was to me, you know? And
sometimes I feel we keep our darkest secrets to ourselves because we have too much pride as Koreans. Sometimes I feel I've shattered my mother's dreams because she came to America in search for a better life. If not for her, maybe through me.
It's just like every time I say that speech, I feel like I'm killing a little part of my mom, and I don't mean it that way. You know, that's not the way I want people to see my speech.
I realized my mother hit me in hopes that the best of me would show. However, I've come to understand that despite cultural differences, abuse still leaves behind hurt feelings and unwanted memories. Therefore, when someone asks me what was more important, avoiding shame or fighting for respect, it would have to be respect. Because through our tribulation, my mother and I now understand each other. Thank you.
I wonder if she feels shame. And the thing is, I don't want her to feel that way. And if, you know, and in a way, I want to be the one who takes the shame, you know? I want people to not just only understand a little bit, but I want them to understand the whole thing. And so maybe that's why I repeat words over and over and over again. I love my mama.
Don't give up your dream. It's really all you have. And I don't want to see you die.
There's much more of senior year at PBS Online. Hear all the music, talk about this episode, and follow the stories you'll only find online at pbs.org. To order the entire senior year series on video cassette or the companion CD to the series featuring Oso Motley, Ani DeFranco, The Coup, and others, call PBS Home Video at 1-800-PLAY-PBS.
This program was made possible by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting, the John D. and Catherine T. MacArthur Foundation, and additional support from Latino Public Broadcasting, National Endowment for the Arts, National Asian American Telecommunications Association, and others. A complete list is available from PBS. And contributions to your PBS station from viewers like you. Thank you.
Is the Army right for me? I mean, is that really what I wanted to do?
He doesn't want to marry me. He says I'm pressuring him. Poor baby, when are you gonna find a catch like me? Don't slap me.
This is PBS.